Welcome back to our science class. So in this video we are going to see a new topic. So this video is for class 4A1 and A2. So the subject we are going to see is science. We are going to see the topic in unit 2. Topic is water cycle. And the session is 23, part 2. Okay? So let's get into the video now. Okay, students, now we are going to see the process of water cycle. So before getting into the process, I just want to explain what is the word water cycle means. Okay, what is water cycle? Okay, how many of you have cycle with you? Yes, how the cycle operates? It keep on rotating. The wheel of the cycle, it keep on rotating, right? Like that, this water cycle means the continuous cycle through which water is circulated by different process like evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So in water cycle we have three process. One is evaporation, another one is condensation, another one is precipitation. So in water cycle how many process we have? Three process we have. One is evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Here I am writing evaporation, condensation precipitation. Okay. So this three is the main process in water cycle. How many process? Three process: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Water cycle has three process: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Okay, so this is the main concept of water cycle. Okay, now we are going to see in brief about evaporation. We are going to see brief about condensation. We are going to see brief about precipitation. Okay, what is the first process in water cycle? Yes, the first process is evaporation. What is the first process? Evaporation. So, in the name, by the name itself, we can say the word evaporation means water gets evaporates. Okay, so in nature water keeps changing its state. Let us see how this happens. Due to the sun's heat, water in oceans and rivers changes into water vapor and rises up. Okay, so water becoming water vapor on heating is called evaporation. Okay, here sea or river or anything, any water sources. Okay, so this is sea and we have sun. So sun produces heat, right? Sun produces heat. So when sun produce heat, the water in the sea get evaporated. The water in the sea get evaporated. Okay. So water becomes water water vapor on heating by sun is known as evaporation. Listen it carefully. So when sun produce heat, the water from any sources get evaporated. So this method is known as, this process is known as evaporation. When sun produce heat, water gets evaporated into water vapor. This process is known as evaporation. Once again, I am repeating. When sun produces heat, water from any sources like rivers, ponds, oceans, anything, okay, from any sources, when sun produces heat, water gets evaporated into water vapor. This process is called evaporation. Okay. Okay, next, what is the second process in water cycle? Yes, condensation. Condensation is the second process in water cycle. Okay, now we'll learn about condensation, the process of condensation. Okay. The water vapor, when comes into contact with cool air, becomes water droplets. This is called condensation. So in the beginning, evaporation, we got water vapor, right? So from the sun's heat, the water gets evaporated into water vapor. So after that, condensation form. So condensation is nothing but the water vapor when comes in contact. Water gets evaporated into water vapor. Okay. So this water vapor, what it will do? It will mix up with the atmospheric air. It will mix up with the atmospheric air and it produces water droplets. Small drops of water. Okay, this is water droplets. This process is known as condensation. Okay, so evaporation is till water vapor is known as evaporation. So from the sea, the water gets evaporated to form water vapor. And the water vapor, it mix up with the atmospheric air and it cools down and it produces water droplets. Okay, so this is condensation. Once again, I am telling, the water gets evaporated due to the heat of sunlight and it becomes water vapor. This water vapor mix up with atmospheric air and it becomes water droplets. See, water droplets. Okay, so this process is known as condensation. The water vapor gets converted into water droplets are known as condensation. Okay, now we'll move on to the next process. Okay, what is the next process? The third one is very good, precipitation. What is this? Precipitation. Okay. What is precipitation? Now we are going to learn. Okay. So till the water droplets we have seen in the previous topic. So the water droplets combine to form clouds. The water droplets continue to combine and they become big and heavy. These water droplets then fall down as rain. This is called precipitation. Very easy one. Okay, so we have water droplets in the atmosphere, in the sky. Okay, so this water droplets, it forms a huge amount of water droplets. More and more amount of water droplets. So this water droplets, at last, it forms as a clouds. Okay, water droplets join together to form as a clouds. So after this cloud formation, what happens? the rain will come. So this process, this all over process is known as precipitation. Okay, the water droplets combine to more amount of water droplets, and at last it will become as a cloud and it produces rain. This process is known as precipitation. Once again, I am telling, water droplets, more amount of water droplets, then it combine together to form a clouds and it produces rain. This process is known as precipitation. Water droplets, more amount of water droplets together to form a cloud and it produces rain. This process is known as precipitation. Okay. Once again, I'm going to explain this. I want everyone to understand it clearly. What is evaporation? First process, evaporation. Second process, condensation. Third process, precipitation. Evaporation, condensation, precipitation. What is evaporation? When water forms as water vapor. What is condensation? Water vapor forms water droplets. What is precipitation? Water droplets form together as a cloud, then rain. This is very important. You can note this also. Okay. So evaporation means formation of water into water vapor. Condensation means formation of water vapor into droplets. And precipitation means formation of water droplets together, it forms clouds and produces rain. Okay, so in book we have water cycle diagram. Everyone look at this water cycle diagram. Okay, now I'm going to explain water cycle by diagram. Okay, so we have water here, we have sea here, and we have sun here. Okay, so we have three processes, right? We have three processes. What is the first one? Evaporation. So first, what will happen? The sun produce heat. The water from the sea, it gets evaporated and it forms water vapor. Water from the sea, it gets evaporated and form water vapor, and this process is known as evaporation. Okay, after evaporation, this water vapor, it forms a water droplets. It forms water droplets. So this water droplets, it bind with many water droplets to form cloud. Okay, this process is known as condensation. No. This droplets, water droplets, formation of water droplets are known as condensation. This water droplets, what it will do? It will join with many water droplets. Many water droplets. And then it forms a cloud. Then it produces rain. Okay, this process will be continuous. Okay, So this process is known as precipitation, right? This is condensation, and this process is known as precipitation. Okay. Evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. First, evaporation occurs, then condensation occurs, then precipitation occurs, and after the rain falls on the ground, what will happen? It will combine with the sea, and after that, evaporation occurs, condensation occurs, precipitation. Then again, evaporation, condensation, precipitation. It is a cyclic process. Okay, this is the process of water cycle. Okay, if you have any doubt in this, you can call me and ask. And I want you to learn the spelling of evaporation, condensation, and precipitation. Okay, thank you, students.